We're Jennie and James. We started our van life journey living in our camper van, and now we build them full time.
Subscribe and follow along on our first build series, where we'll show you all the tips and tricks that we've learned along the way. Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back. Now we're moving on to our solar panels. So we're just gonna explain how to set them up in parallel series with MC4 connectors, and then we'll install them and we'll show you all the steps.
So we got our solar panels from Renogy. They've got American and Canadian websites, which is really handy for us. We're in Vancouver, Canada. Normally when we ship from the States, there's crazy costs with that. So it's really nice to have a Canadian site, and they just supply really easy to put together packages. So we decided to get a 300 watt one this time, and it comes with three different solar panels, all 100 watt each. It comes with all the connectors, all the wires, the charge controller, everything you need to have the full setup. So we really recommend them. They're a great company. So yeah, we're gonna show you how to set that up.
And then we'll link it in our description below.
All right, so we've got our three solar panels lined up here, just so we can show you how everything works. It might look a little scary at first, but it's super simple, as you will quickly see. So initially, on the back of every solar panel, they already have these connections made, and these are just really simple positive and negative connections. You can tell which one's positive because it's got a little red ring and a little plus sign there, and the negative one is just black. So that's just an easy way to remember which one is which. When you're linking them up in parallel, you need to make sure that you're just connecting red to red and black to black. So we're gonna take our first two positive ones here, and then we're gonna take our first connector bit that comes in the package, and then you're just gonna clip both pieces in like that.
This is what the MC4 connectors look like up close. So just for example, take the positive one. You can see that on the left side, it can take two positive ends and then it funnels down into one. Same for the negative, it takes two negatives and funnels it down into one.
So there's our first red to red connection. Now we're gonna do the same for the negatives. Sweet. So there's those done. So that's two panels connected together. If you just had two, you could just take it like that and then connect your wires that they then supply. But we have three, so we're just gonna do one more. So all you need to do three panels is just two more connectors. You're gonna connect them like that. So this is the positive one, and this is a positive end again. So clipping that together, and then you've got your last and final positive wire. There we go.
Three panels side by side like this doesn't leave a lot of slack in the lines, but if you arrange your panels differently, it can leave a little more slack. You can also purchase extensions from Renogy if you need to separate your panels more.
And then your last connector. So you're gonna clip this end into one of these, like so, and then take your last negative wire and connect that there as well. So now when you had six different wires, they all funnel down into these two endpoints. So the next two components are the wires that are gonna connect to your charge controller. It's really important when connecting these. This one does have a red end, but it's gonna be the negative wire because it connects to the female end of this, which is the negative one. So when you click that together, the end of this is just a piece of wire like that. And so you need to make sure that you're labeling this as you're feeding it through your van, so that when you connect it to your controller, you know that this is the negative one and that this is the positive one. So that's that. With these little ends, you'd obviously uncoil that, feed it through your van where you need it to go. Those are just a really simple connection that will go into the bottom of your charge controller. Okay, so you're gonna take your PV plus wire, and the PV is the solar panel wires, and the plus one will go into this slot in the bottom, and the negative one will go into this slot there. And in order to tighten them up, you're just gonna take a screwdriver, it looks like a Phillips head, unscrew this a little bit on both ends, put the wire in, and then tighten it down onto the wire. So that's how those connect. So the charge controller is the device that's essentially just gonna funnel the electricity from the solar panels safely into your batteries. And so this just makes sure that you have a nice steady current going into your batteries and it doesn't mess anything up. So the last piece of the puzzle is these two wires. These ones are just gonna go from your charge controller.
And got little toilet bowl ends on them.
So these ones are gonna go from your charge controller to your battery. And then once again, it's labeled pretty simply there. It's got the plus and minus for your battery. So you're gonna connect them just like you did the solar panel ones into there. And then when you connect them to the rings of your battery, they've already got these toilet bowl connectors. So you can just set those on your battery, screw them on, you're good to go.
It's important to note that the PV or solar panel connections should be made last if you're building your van outside in the daytime. This is because the sun is actually going to be feeding energy through the solar panels and then into the wires that you've connected to them. If you've connected those wires to your controller already, but it's not connected to your battery, that can actually damage your controller. And if they're just loose wires not connected to anything, then they're potentially live wires loose in your van. So the solution is to insulate those wires with tape or something until you're ready to use them. Or the safest way to do it is to just connect those MC4 connectors on the solar panels themselves as the last step after everything else is already done.
Okay, so just a little recap of what I've been doing here. I decided to get all of these brackets on before I go up on the roof and mount it there, just because it's gonna be easier to do it down here. And the best way to do it, I find, is if you take the bolt and then you take this little piece, you put that on, and then a washer. You're gonna take this and put it up through your hole wherever you decide, like that, and then another washer, and then the bolt on top of that. Screw it on. I normally just hold like a wrench to hold the bolt under there, and then another wrench to tighten it on this side. So when we mount these panels on the roof, we find the best way is to actually overlap these brackets a little bit. It's not gonna sit wobbly because they'll be really tight on the ground, but you can just screw two holes down there instead of having them separate and have four. It just saves a little space on your roof, and it means you're just drilling less holes in your van. So that's what we're gonna do.
We actually ended up mounting them a different way in order to save space. As you can see in these photos, we put the brackets on the ends of the panels so that when we mounted them, they were flush against each other. This saved us space on our roof, which gave us more flexibility when installing our fan and skylight.
So we just wanted to make a note that all the connections that we showed you should be done on top of the van. Otherwise, if they're all connected, it'd be really hard to get them all on top. So I think that's it for today. We just wanted to show you guys how to put it all together in parallel. If you have any questions, just let us know in the comments, and good luck. Thank you.